Hello and welcome to Midtown USA by CCS 101. I'm Eustace Farmer and I hope you're all doing well today. So, what are we doing here? You might look and say, well, this is just Westbridge Hills. Well, wrong. It is Westbridge Hills, but in my opinion, it's a very well done remake of Westbridge Hills. So if you loved Westbridge Hills out of the box from Giants and you just kind of got bored with it and moved away from it, this is going to breathe new passion back into you for Westbridge. If you never liked Westbridge before or never bothered with it, this is going to make you want to bother with it, and I think you're really going to like it if you gave it a chance. He's introduced some really great features, and he's moved things around in a way that I really think that it helps everything flow better. So a job very well done. So that's one of the reasons why you're finding this map review on the Mapper's Paradise channel. No, he's not a member of Mapper's Paradise, but he is a great supporter of Mapper's Paradise and an FSUK MVP, and he's worked very hard for many months to accomplish this, and I would hate for it to go unnoticed. So that's what we're doing here today. Okay, so let's start out over here. You got your tipping point for your silos. That's quite obvious. Now, one thing that may not be quite obvious that you might be scratching your head about is when you download the folder after you unpack it, you're going to find that there's going to be a little picture in there. And it's basically to show you what silos are for what. So over here, this little spout is for all your standard grains. And then over here, and let me give you the proper view. There we go. That's about right. Doesn't have to be exact. Okay, so there we go. So as you see here, on this side is your sunflower and soybeans, and over here is your oats and rye. And, you know, your little house is over here. So, and there's the downspout for the default grains. So, kind of explains it all right there for you, and that little picture is included. Now, the text you will have in your picture is not like this, same color, but I just put a stroke around it because I find it easier for my old eyes to see. But other than that, this is what you're going to get. So while we're in here, I took the liberty of taking a screenshot of each one of the maps just to have a little side-by-side comparison so you can see, you know, certain little things. So we still at 21 fields, but he's rearranged the fields. He's rearranged things on the map and improved some of the fields. So like here, 16 over here is now field 21, and it's a bit larger. He took advantage of the space around the borders. And this is all pasture for your cows. Well, it's divided in half here. So half is pasture, and then this half is to mow grass. So to feed your cows or to make hay bales or whatever you like. And then 16 used to be 17, so forth and so on. If you like to sell chicken eggs, well, guess what? You got four different places to sell chicken eggs now. he's rearranged some of the sell points and tipping points, and he's added some. Done a really great job. So he's just taken a great map and made it even better. Okay, so let's get down from here. We'll put away our drone, wink wink. So before I get into why I have this little trailer here, we'll have a look around the yard a little bit more real quick. So over here obviously is your sugar beet and potato and your wood chip storage. And then if you neander around the corner here, you've got your fertilizer fill-up station and your seeds. And also your soil mod components, all your herbicides for soil mod if you like playing with soil mod. And then over here we got the chickens, little chicken coop there. And then their next door neighbors is the sheep. And there they are running along here. So he made a great use of this space before that pretty much served no purpose. You know, unless you like getting in your dirt bike and, you know, running up and down the hills here, which is actually kind of fun. Go a little crazy sometimes. And then over here is where you got your wool pallets. That's where you'll be collecting those. And then around back here, we have another interesting little element. So this is a silage fermentation silo. And you can't see it because I have my HUD off. There we go. So as you see there, it's the, you know, it ferments the grass and so forth and makes silage. And you'll get it dispensed out of here. And you'll tip over here. So all your grass clippings and so forth will go in there, and then it'll make silage for you, which is really awesome. And then over here, I've used this on other maps. It's, you know, to grind up the hay bales and stuff like that. And yowza. So that's running full steam and ready to go. Plenty of storage on this map, and there's storage in unexpected places too as an added bonus, which is really nice, and I'll even be showing you that. So you got a nice little workshop here. Then over here, it looks like this is where you'll blow in the straw for your cows. And it looks like the manure will be collected over here. So it doesn't look like you have to muck it out, and then your slurry will be obviously over here. And here's the feeding. Very nice. And this is nice that you could drive right in the field here. It's got the cow grate to keep them from escaping. And those work very well in real life. And so what does this mean? Well, you can mow this down. It's added in with this over here. So you can do this, and you can, you know, cut the grass down over here too. So that's fantastic. This is a nice big space over here. Okay, so it looks like milk is automatically collected at midnight, because there's no tipping or loading trigger for that. So that's all right, because there's plenty to do on this farm. And then here's equipment storage, and there was stuff in here, but I set some stuff up to show you little demonstrations. So it gives you a lot of nice equipment to get started with. So you can just get to it and dig right in there. Even when you get those great demands, you got a truck to haul it all down there in just a couple of trips. Another barn here. I just love storage. If you've watched any of my Let's Plays, you'll understand. I put sheds all over the place. I've been told I might have a little problem. I need to go to shed therapy. Okay. So over here, you have an anhydrous ammonia station. So I'm sure some of you have played using this before, but for those of you that don't know what anhydrous ammonia is, it's an efficient and widely used source of nitrogen fertilizer. So that's what you got over here. Pretty cool. Nice little addition. And this all used to be the sheep farm down here on the standard map. And then over here is the flour mill. So he's kind of jazzed that up a bit too. And of course, he teases us with these, you'll see, like, beautiful old tractors all over the place and equipment, but they're not, you know, working. So it's a tease. There we go. So that's your tipping point. And as you saw from the map tour, it's a really cool freight train that comes through here, and it runs from one end down to the other, past the train station on the other end over by town. So really cool. So as you see here, the car dealership hasn't changed. It's still the same old nice dealership. There's our milk factory and our drive-in theater. And this is a great place to plant trees if you want to plant saplings. This makes a nice little tree farm up here. I've done that on the map before, and that turned out good. So you got some storage down here. And there's our lumber yard where you can sell your wood. So very convenient if you grow your trees up there. You just drive them down the hill. And there's your biomass for your wood chips. And then over here, this is the restaurant. So, and it accepts potatoes over here. So that's cool. And I think you could sell your chicken eggs over here too. There was a spot down here for chicken eggs. Yep, right over there. And you can check your balance and take out more money, too, if you can't pay the bill for dinner. Here's our biogas facility, and that's been ramped up a little bit. And there's a fueling station here, a little biofuel. And I'm going to show you a little something with these hoppers, because you can sell sugar beets and potatoes down here, too. And I'm going to show you how. And then you got some great storage over here to keep all your silaging equipment undercover. All right. And then this used to be the previous cattle farm, and now it's a nice big field to work with, so that's awesome. Added a little field space to that. So while we're passing back overhead, I'll just let you know, right where those little trailers are, that's the vehicle reset point. So when you reset them from the dealer, that's where they'll materialize. Now, down in here in town, now, if you've played the old Westbridge map, you'll know that there was a nice barn for storage in the center of town. And we still have that now, but it's got some nice gates on it. So he's added some gates to that. Got great sounds to them. And there's also another building. And I just happened upon it, actually, by accident. So, this is really cool here. Another nice added storage facility. Or maybe it could be your fire department. Hey, hey. Whatever you like. And now I'll show you something else that's really handy. Well, here's your little information center, if you ever did use that little telephone thing. So I guess this is where you come into town. You'd come through this tunnel. Come through the mountain into town, and it tells you a little bit about the place. The home of the Clean Valley Initiative, featuring 100% renewable energy. And then it has a little map over here. So founded in the 70s by a few forward-thinking individuals with unique vision. Now, with the new Clean Valley Initiative, it's a great place to live. And it's got things marked out on the map here. So if you ever get a little bit jumbled up and you're in the area, come on over and have a look. So down here in the park, there's a little bank where you can, again, check your loan balance or take out a loan. Put yourself more in hock. And I'm going to show you some stuff down here with those little trailers regarding the train station. Like I said, some folks may have played a map with these similar features, and they're, you know, very well versed in what to do. But some of you newer folks may not. So I'm going to show you, you know, what to tip where. All right, back at the main farm. Let's go ahead, fill up our cedar a little bit. So I just wanted to give you a little demonstration of the different textures. The gates have nice sound, too. If I can shut up long enough so you can hear them. Okay. So we're doing it a little backwards, but I just want to give you the idea. Really nice soil textures. I like them a lot. So there's our seeded texture. Nice. Yeah, so we won't need to see cultivated, me and my infinite wisdom here, because it's already cultivated. But I want to show you the plow texture. Don't judge me on my straight lines. This is just a demonstration. All right. So there's our plow texture. And it does have the furrows. They're a little hard to see, but they're there. Okay, so last but not least, let's load up a little bit of barley. Let's go sell some stuff. One thing while I'm here that I should mention, let me go ahead and show you. This map has been very stable. Take that off. As you see here, there's no errors. It's all clean. All right. So this is a nice way to get a little bit of a drive in from, you know, on the ground. See things from that perspective. So as you know, there's several different ways to go, but we'll take somewhere a little bit more scenic here. Looking like we might get a little rain later today. Clouds got little bit of darkness to them. I love all the wildflowers growing too. Nice grass textures. Now, you're going to have to be careful if you like that grass border around the edge of your field. You're going to have to be careful when you're plowing and cultivating and stuff, because that grass will get deleted if you hit it with the plow or the cultivator. So if that bothers you, you know, leave a little bit of a dirt edge. Because just like in real life, you know, you hit the grass, you know, with one of your implements, and you're going to have to come back out and, you know, reseed it. Another thing while I'm here, just to show you, this is really cool. He's got the little real estate signs up. Midtown Realty, Century 21. I love that. Just adds a little bit more character to the map, you know? And here comes the train. All right. That was pretty cool. Okay, so our first tipping point over here, and I'm focusing down here because the other ones are pretty much straightforward. It's very obvious. There we go. So you have to make sure that you have the correct tipping side of your trailer, you know, obviously. We can do it on the side or, you know, back up. I'm going to back up because it just makes it easier here. And it's already set to the back, so. And you'll notice the little trap door will pop open. So this is where you'll dump your barley. As you see. There it goes. All right. And now we'll do our sugar beets. Just a little bit. So you pull up to the second or third bay here, and you'll see the little tipping sign come up in the lower right corner. There it goes. So either one of these here. Just to show you it works, we're going to save some for our next destination. Okay, so here we're coming up on the biogas. Going in backwards. Okay, so this is what I wanted to show you over here. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make sure that you have, I think it's $240,000. Let me see if it'll register when I'm on foot. Yeah, projected plant size. So you need to purchase it for 240,000 pounds, dollars or euros, wherever you are, live in the world. So it will say, it'll say enter, and then that's how you would purchase it. So let me go ahead and give myself some money here. So I can increase the plant size by paging up. And as you see here, it's going up. And this is the same button to take screenshots, so forgive the little window in the lower corner. But it's going up in value. So we're at 150%. 205%. Really cool. So the more money you make, the more money you can invest in here, and the more profit you can pull out of here. So you can dump your sugar beets and potatoes in here. And it's the same for both. I'll just show you one trailer. I know you don't know me, but you can trust me. So there you go. Back right up in there. You can also dump them in a placeable heap and then shovel them in there for a little bit more of a realistic thing. Or you can do, you know, placeable heap and stick a conveyor belt, you know, between the heap and the hopper and do it that way. So I also noticed that this hopper will turn on at certain times of the night. So you're not going to be, it seems to me that you're not going to be like, you know, doing this till the cows come home. So it's a little bit more of a realistic aspect to it. Okay, so the last place, the Down Home Cafe. So there you go. Potatoes only. Okay, there you go. There'll be plenty of baked potatoes and French fries for everybody tonight. All right, we're just going to park this up over here. And then I'm going to show you a little bit about what I was talking about with the folder and the compost trailer fix. So I'll be with you in a flash. All right, so the first thing I wanted to show you is this is the Google Doc that I'm going to share out. So basically, I copy and pasted what was on the FSUK website under his description. I'll show you that. And, you know, where he provided all the links. And I just kind of transposed it into a document so I could make the links active. So that's what this is here. So you can click on the link, come in here, and have a field day. Whatever you need is in here. The map download is in here. Make sure you have the 1.04 version of the animation map trigger. He said otherwise it's going to throw errors. As you see here, I put it in bold. So if you wanted the soil management, it's here. Everything is here. So look through and see what you have and what you don't have. But down here is where you'll get, now this is to, you'll need the Cott Universal Trailer Pack for the fueling aspect to to fuel up your composter with diesel. So you'll need that. And then this is the compost trailer. And then he's got a script to modify that to work on here. So you'll download this, and this is what you'll get. Brantner underscore compost zip. You'll extract it. Then you'll get this. So these are the files that we're going to replace. We're going to the mod description, the Brantner XML itself, and then in textures, we're going to add the seed diffuse. Okay, so that one I already did, so that's why it's dark. Okay, so what you're basically going to do is you'll unzip his folder. You'll come in here, compost trailer fix. What do you know? Copy this one and that one, and then we'll come back for the seed diffuse as well. So you'll just copy it. And over here, just click anywhere and paste. It'll say, you want to replace it? Yep. And there you go. Now we'll do the seed diffuse. Copy. And paste it anywhere in here. And it'll ask you, you want to replace? Yes, you do. And there you go. And then that's it. And then you'll just hit Control A and send a zip. And, you know, make a zip file out of it, which I did here. And I renamed mine, you know, Brantner Compost Fixed, you know, that way I can keep both trailers. So, and that's it. And then just slide it into your mods folder and you're good to go. Now, he also has in here, when you unpack it, there's needed files. So if you don't have any of these mods, he's already given them to you here. Just slide them into your mods folder. And then, of course, here's the little farm picture, the little silo picture, and then there's a description text here so you can read all about it. And it tells you the sale point. So this is a nice quick reference if you wanted to copy that to your desktop. You can even print it out. So, and he goes into great detail about different aspects of the farm, you know. So this is a good read. And it's pretty much the same as what you'll read on the FSUK website. So it's all right here too, but that little text document is handy to have to print out if you need to. Okay, just to round things off, here we are up at the top section of the map by field 8 and 9. And there's the warehouse. And there's your tipping point at the warehouse. And then here's your garden center. You can sell your compost over there. Pretty cool. And then over here, an unexpected little surprise as well. And I'm glad I remembered to show you. So if you're working in field 9 and you're running low on fuel, well, you have a nice little storage shed up here. And then inside, got a little gas pump, and it does work. So I would recommend parking your vehicle outside and bringing the hose outside and do it. Otherwise, you'll blow yourself up in there. Not my idea of a good time. So, yeah. So what better way to close out a map tour and say goodbye to you on the good old American baseball field with the old glories waving high and proud. So I hope you've enjoyed this little map tour, and I hope it's given you some good, valuable information. If I did skip over anything that you know of, I do apologize. Please do let me know. If there's anything I can help you with, any questions that I can answer for you, I will do my best to answer them. If I don't know them, I will find out. So please do feel free to message or PM me or however you'd like to do it. I'm happy to help you if I can. So that being said, thank you very much for joining me. And wherever in the world that you call home, I hope you're having a great morning, afternoon, or evening. And until we meet again, take good care of yourself. And bye-bye for now.